Omni Edition Sports presents from Garden City High School in Garden City, Michigan, Cougar football. Tonight, the Garden City Cougars take on the Romulus Eagles. It is homecoming 2019. Hi, everybody. This is Dan York. Jeremy Jenkins will be along in just a little while from field level as we get ready to bring you this annual tradition all across the country. It is homecoming for the Garden City Cougars. And Garden City coming into this game with a 3-2 record. Romulus comes in with a 1-4 record. Romulus has struggled this season. As we understand it, their quarterback today is going to be Paris Patterson. Their normal quarterback, number two, Dior Brown, is unavailable for this game. For Garden City, it's been Ethan Chelloa all season. He had 148 yards against Crestwood last week in Garden City's first win over Crestwood in 7 years. As we said, it's homecoming, so lots of activities. The parade, the assembly today will have the crowning of the homecoming queen at halftime, and we are about ready to go. Tinsley kicking off for Garden City, and we're underway. It is homecoming for 2019. This will be a penalty as the ball is kicked out of bounds. It'll be moved to the 35-yard line. And Jeremy Jenkins is on the sideline in front of the Cougar Crazies. And Jeremy, a big day for Garden City, a big football game for Garden City. But as we talked about, Romulus comes in depleted as they're down to a different quarterback, Paris Patterson.
Yeah, Paris Patterson is a sophomore, and he is starting for what we assume is the first time. I mean, they have a junior quarterback, and that is Dor Brown. He's going to be out for this one. So we're expecting a pretty run-heavy game from both teams tonight, especially Garden City. We expect them to try and control the clock, control the pace of the game. I got the Cougar Crazies going nuts behind me as we're about set to run our first play of the game. And Romulus is going to be starting on offense, so we'll see if the Cougar defense can hold strong here in the early going.
All right, a cool day, our first cool day this season. Mostly temperatures have been in the 80s and 90s. It was at 90 degrees earlier this week. As I see the ball being moved back to the 20-yard line, I'm not sure exactly what that's about. Our official chose not to wear a microphone tonight, so we're a little in the dark. But 54 degrees at kickoff, cloudy skies, but it is dry, and we're ready to go here at Garden City High School. And we will confirm at quarterback. This is number 11, Paris Patterson. And he'll give a handoff to big number 80. He'll be tackled in the backfield. First play of the game, they give it to a number we don't have.
And that was a great job by the Garden City defense, stringing that out down the line the entire way. Romulus tried pulling their guards, running that sweep, and having number 80, which I'll try to get confirmation on his name here in a little bit. But a great run, or a great defensive stop there, I should say, from the Cougar defensive line early.
We will be honest with you folks, Romulus did not send us anything. We were able to get a roster, and that was all. We don't have any stats for roster. We couldn't find any stats in any of the newspapers. There was nothing online. So we have what we have, and what that is a lineup that doesn't have number 80 on it. So a loss on the play, we'll call it second down 13. For Romulus at about their own 17-yard line. Again, not sure why the ball ended up at the 20-yard line instead of at the 35 with the illegal kick out of bounds. Did not see a flag on the play. So Patterson under center, and he'll hand it off again. No, he'll hold on to it. And Patterson is tackled first by 88 for Garden City. Derek Vanderwater, who comes into this game with 11 tackles on the season. So this will make a third down now for Romulus and about 7 yards to go.
And that play right there just demonstrated why Romulus can be dangerous in this game against Garden City. Coach Jim Baker was talking to us before the game, and they have very fast players on the Romulus offense that they're going to try to utilize, and we saw that from Campbell on that play.
Garden City beat Romulus last season. There's the snapped Patterson. He goes across with a screen pass. He'll pick up the first down fumble. Let's see who picked it up. So the pass was completed to Thomas, I believe. A fumble on the play. He recovered it. The spot not very friendly, but this could have been after the fumble. But it will be a first and 10 at the 30-yard line now for Romulus at their own 30-yard line.
And now it looks like Romulus is going to pick up the pace a little bit here, too, and get Garden City on their heels. and start to move the ball after that first down.
And there's a give up to middle to number seven, Eric Massey. And once again, he's met by that Garden City defensive line. Joseph Groves, he's the man in charge out there for Garden City. He's had 50 tackles this season, 31 of those solos.
And the Romulus offensive line has some decent size too, but visibly you can see, especially Logan Taylor, number 54 there for Garden City, he's kind of towering over everyone there. So we'll see if that D-line can get some penetration again.
And Romulus, well, there's a fumble in the backfield. And the quarterback picked it up, I believe.
Yep, Patterson was able to get that. I got this back corner view. I'm kind of near the goalposts here. He was able to pick that up, and he actually lost a couple yards on the play.
So another third down and long, this time third down and 11 for Romulus. Big day here at Garden City High School. They had a really nice assembly earlier in the day today. Garden City kids really fired up. Nice crowd coming in, still coming in here at Garden City High School. You saw in the shot earlier the big Cougar crazy crowd in the stands.
It's definitely filling up now too, Dan.
So Patterson, back to pass. Patterson with a looping liner completed to Christian Chambers. That ball hung up in the air for a long time.
And from field level, that looked like that was tailor-made for an interception. It was pretty close, but number five, like you said, that is Chambers went up and made the catch, and an impressive catch over the DB from Garden City.
Devin White was the defender. He chose to stay back and not go for the interception. Got to make a decision there as a defensive back whether you go for the ball, but of course if you don't get it, you might get burned for a touchdown, and Romulus will call a timeout. First and 10 from the 49-yard line. Dan York along with the Jeremy Jenkins. He's on the sideline tonight. Glad you can join us here on Omnidition Sports, GCTV. Big crew here tonight for our broadcast, and we thank all of them for being here today. Now, Garden City and Romulus, this is a conference game in the Western Wayne Athletic Conference. You see, Romulus comes in struggling at 1-4. Garden City 3-1 in the conference. A big win over Crestwood last week here at Garden City High School. So Garden City still has Robichaud coming up on their schedule along with Melvindale. So Garden City in the hunt for a conference championship as well as in the hunt for a playoff spot. You need at least 6 wins is the norm. And because of Garden City's schedule, they'll need 6 wins to get into the playoffs.
And 6 wins is absolutely feasible. And this is a must win for that playoff push.
There's a handoff in the backfield and a loss and a fumble on the play. Let's see, Garden
City. That's Garden City ball. Got it. That's Garden City ball, absolutely.
And they do.
And I'll get out of the way here before I get run over.
32, Ian Will, who's had a great season for Garden City, comes up with a fumble recovery, and the Cougars will have it in Romulus territory. Let's watch it again.
Yeah, you could see it come out at the very end, and it went into the lap of Will. He's able to wrestle it away.
I believe that was Devin White, but I'm not sure. That was pulling down the running back Massey as he fumbled. There you see our Cougar crazy and our Cougar crazies and our Cougar marching band, and Garden City's got it. Chucky Gassum at quarterback, and no surprise, he gives it to Ethan Chelowa, and Chelowa has at least 9, maybe 10 for a first down. We'll see where they spot it. Just short.
That's what we expect to see this entire game. Is Chelowa running those buck sweeps, running up the middle, and then you're going to see Nazarowski in there as well as a speed back to give the Romulus defense a different look.
So no wideouts in this configuration. And Chelowa does not take it. Gassum rolls out to his right. Gassum with a little dump pass. They give it to him? They did. Pass completed to Devin White, so that's the first down. Looked like Brett Favre there, didn't it?
Yeah, that was an interesting little shovel pass there, or I should say push pass. Kind of reminded me of Tim Tebow jumping in the air there, too.
The difference is Gassum's still playing football. Let's watch Garden City gets the first down as Gassum just kind of jumps into the air and flips it ahead to White. And a first and 10 for Garden City at the Romulus 30. There's the give to Chelowa. Chelowa with some blockers. Chelowa picks up 4, maybe 5 on the play.
Chelowa with the carry. 45
Ethan Cello has had a monster season for Garden City.
He has, and he's approaching that 1,000-yard rushing mark. He's probably a game or two away from that. Just needing 200 and I believe it was...
About 280.
Yeah, about 280 to get there. So if he's on his current average per game, he should be getting there pretty soon.
He's averaging 6.5 yards a carry in 2019.
And that's really telling of how good this offensive line for Garden City has been so far this year.
And we've got a whistle. And our official indicates offsides against Romulus, so a 5-yard penalty. It'll give Garden City a second down and short now.
That was another thing that Coach Baker told us before the game, too, is that this Romulus team is fairly undisciplined from what they've seen on film and from what they've heard from other coaches around the league.
Well, we've played some undisciplined teams that were very fast, and they've given us trouble in the past. We'll see how Garden City does with the Eagles here tonight.
All about that ball control.
And a quick give. This one is to Michael Nazarowski, who has the second most yards gained for Garden City. He picks up the first down.
And that's that speed factor that we were expecting from Nazarowski compared to Chellowa. Chellowa has his speed as well, but Nazarowski is a bit quicker, and he gives that defense a different look and the offense a bit more juice.
Nazarowski, a junior, will be here next year after Chellowa graduates. So a first and 10, looks like it's right on the 10, but they've got the sticks up. No, they've dropped it. So it's a first and goal at the 10-yard line. Chellowa in the backfield. White, one of the wideouts to give to Chellowa. Chellowa battling ahead, and Chellowa gets inside the 5-yard line.
Looked like a simple trap play there, Dan. Run right up the middle, keep that defense honest because Garden City's been mainly running towards off the tackle so far in this game, so got to mix it up and keep it going up the middle too.
So second down and 5 for Garden City, second and goal from the 5. As you look right into the Cougar huddle, Jason Merrow, our chief camera operator on that lift camera. Thanks to Gary Carter for getting us that today, and thanks for Garden City Rental for getting us a lift last week for the game. Big man in the backfield, Grove. He carried it the other day. He's a decoy, though, and it goes to Chellowa, and Chellowa is down to the 1.
It looked like that handoff from Gassum to Chellowa was a little bobbled, too, just from this angle. But Chellowa able to hold on to it, get down to the 1-yard line, and the Cougars are knocking down.
Grove at 265 lines up in the backfield, but he's just there to help with the blocking. And you see Chellowa get to the 1. So third and goal from the 1-yard line for Garden City. Their first drive of the game. Romulus had the ball first and fumbled. So Grove still back there as a blocking back. And pushing it ahead is the quarterback. Let's see.
Our official's calling it a touchdown, Dan.
And a touchdown as Chucky Gassum, number 12, carries it into the end zone. And Garden City gets on the board first. The last game, all 3 touchdowns were scored by Chellowa. This one is a 1-yard carry by Gassum. And the Cougars are on the board.
And just a methodical drive there, pretty much what we expected from Garden City. No passing on that drive. Just march down the field and punch it into the end zone on short yard situation. Good third and goal play and a good push by Gassum and his O-line and Joseph Grove as well.
Austin Allman will line up to attempt the point after. And it's up and good, and Garden City goes ahead 7-0 early on here at Garden City High School. Nice drive by the Cougars.
And it really was, and this is what we come to expect from this Garden City team, is a grinded out approach, a grinded out mentality. We see it on offense, we see it on defense, and I know that the coaching staff is very happy about that first drive because I'm sure that's what they were preaching all week in practice, is ball control, time of possession, and keeping the ball out of the hands of these dangerous Romulus skill players.
So Romulus will get the football back. Garden City very effective on defense that first drive. On a homecoming Friday here in Garden City, cloudy skies, nice crowd. We've had rain for both of our varsity games this year that have kept the crowds down a little bit. Decent showing here on a homecoming.
We got a great crowd here tonight, Dan, and especially the Cougar Crazies are in full force now. They are filling that section up.
Thomas is deep in Garden City as they do. Kicks the ball normally pretty close to the sideline, and this is Eric Massey, the running back for Romulus, and he is dangerous. Massey over the 45, over the 50, over the 45, and Massey is tackled just short of the 35-yard line. So rather than having Eric Massey deep, they bury him in the middle and kick it right to him, and that's probably the most dangerous offensive play for the most dangerous offensive player for the Eagles.
And the coaching staff from Garden City needs to know where Massey is at all times, because they kicked it right to him on that little pooch kick there. They know he's one of the players to look out for, and they need to make sure that they limit his touches, especially on kickoffs like that. And this is worst case scenario for Garden City right now.
Romulus at the Cougar 35-yard line. They trail it 7-0. Massey in the backfield. Three wideouts. And to give to number 7. And Massey fights his way ahead for at least 4 yards on the play.
Looks like they're only giving him 2 on that one.
Well, break for Garden City. So brings a 2nd-and-8 situation.
I've been really impressed by the D-line from Garden City so far, and pretty much all year, too. They've been doing a really good job at bottling up the run.
They have had a good season. Clock running, 3:48 remaining here in the first quarter. Patterson looks to throw. The right hander across the middle, intercepted. Right into the hands of Devin White. White trying to get a couple of yards out of this, gets himself over the 35 to the 37, and 1st-and-10 for Garden City. I don't even know who that was intended for.
I was just gonna reflect the exact same thing, Dan. I didn't see a receiver in the area at all.
Well, I guess like it's the deep man
right
there.
Right.
I think he wanted to throw it to number 6, Thomas, but it was way short, and Devin White. It would have been hard for White not to catch that.
Yeah, it was right in his chest. So
first
a good heads-up play there by Devin White.
So 1st-and-10 for the Cougars. They get the ball back with 3:34 remaining. Chelloa in the backfield along with Gassum. Chucky gives it to Chelloa over right tackle. Chelloa battles his way ahead. He's still on his feet. Chelloa up to the 41, 42-yard line. A flag on the play as a couple of players got tangled up.
That is a face mask against Romulus. I didn't see who it was for Romulus.
54, Chaz Tennant was the Cougar player.
Yep, he got tied up. He got held on the face mask.
So this is going to turn into a massive gain. There you see, and reaching in with the face mask right there is Thomas, Matthew Thomas. I thought it was the battle going on away from the play, but it was a face mask on the actual carry, as Jeremy said.
Well, if that's the case, I thought it was the one away from the play as well.
It was actually on the ball carry.
Okay, so that's 2 face masks on 1 play. I guess the refs just got to pick which one.
They picked the one that had an impact on the play. So 1st-and-10 at the 32. You and I both saw the same thing away from the play. It's Chelloa. Hope he never gets tired. Chelloa up over the 25 to the 24.
That's why they conditioned for this. They're ready. They're ready.
Well, I'll tell you what, the cooler temperatures, I imagine, are very helpful.
It is, definitely. That makes it a lot easier, and it's easier for guys to stay hydrated as well. Man, Chelloa is just tough to bring down. I mean, it's awesome being down at this level, being able to see it. He is a load to bring down, and he's just as big as the defensive lineman from Romulus.
3 receivers, and Chucky Gassum will take it himself. With the defense spread out, Chucky Gassum takes it right over center. So it's 1st-and-10 at the 15.
And this has just been a dream quarter so far for Garden City. 2 turnovers forced on Romulus, And they're looking to eat up some more clock, take a two-score lead.
And Thomas got tangled up with Vandewater on that one. So there's a lot going on away from the ball. First and 10. Chelua has some blocking.
That was good pursuit by number 80. Again, we don't have him on our roster, but he chased that play down. Chelua got a little bottled up there by the defensive end on his left side, and a good job by number 80 able to track him down.
We've got a Weston Graves who's number 79, but I don't know if that is the young man or not.
So this is second and, let's call it, 8 for Garden City. Just if you get 3 or 4 yards at a crack, you're doing pretty good.
Right up the middle is Chelua.
And that's even better.
Right up the middle was Chelua, and another Garden City touchdown. Wow. Just lightning fast.
He is. It's surprising how fast he is for how big he is as well. On our roster, we have him listed as 180 pounds, but I tell you, he looks bigger than that to me.
So about a 12-yard run for Chelua. Garden City's on top, trying to make it 14-0 right here. And once again, Allman will attempt the point after, right into our lift camera. It is up and it is good, and a 14-0 lead for Garden City. Here in the first quarter with a minute 40 remaining.
Fantastic start, and the Cougars are giving this homecoming crowd something to really celebrate here so far. And this is exactly how you wanted to start off. I know that the coaching staff for Garden City didn't have a whole lot of material on Romulus as well. So they were kind of a little hesitant on what they were going to be expecting as well. But so far, so good. They forced 2 turnovers, 2 touchdowns on their first 2 drives. It's been a great start for the Cougars.
So Matthew Thomas and Eric Massey will be deep for Romulus on this kickoff. Well, I guess if you're Garden City, your game plan doesn't change much anyways, depending on the opponent. Your defensive scheme might change based on what you know they're going to do. But on offense, you know what Garden City's going to do. They're going to give the ball to Chelo.
Absolutely. And if it ain't broke, don't fix it, because it's been working wonders so far, not just this game, but this entire season.
So Tinsley will kick off as the cheerleaders rattle off 14 push-ups. This one will bounce, and it is a live football, and Romulus will pick it up. Kind of a slow reaction there to pick the ball up. I think sometimes kids forget that it's a live ball.
Yeah, especially if you're not normally one of the receiving players that's back deep the entire way and you're mainly on the field as a blocker. If you kick the ball towards them, and that's part of the strategy behind it if you're Garden City, they might not know exactly what to do with the ball, as we saw right there.
So Miguel Smith with the run back for the Eagles gives them a first and 10 at about their 27-yard line. Jeremy, how you like it on the field?
Oh, it's awesome. It's awesome down here. Feeling that atmosphere. Got the cheerleaders down near the players. I can't say I've been down on the field for a game since I was in high school.
Want to thank Christian Gibbons and Jason Merrow and Zach King for all the work they did to make that work today.
Looks like we might have had to change at quarterback there. That was Jalen Culver on the handoff.
And that was Chelua with the tackle.
So it might be quarterback by committee here. We're not quite sure yet, but that was Culver for Romulus. It looks like the coaching staff, Coach Charles Searcy, trying to find some answers with Dor Brown out.
Well, we've got 2 8s listed too, so we've got a Cortez Johnson and a Jalen Culver. So,
well, then if I had to guess, it's Cortez Johnson. They got him listed as a skill receiver.
And with the run there was Massey. And it's going to bring up a 3rd down and about 6.
It'll be interesting here to see if Garden City chooses to put a spy on the quarterback, knowing how dangerous they are with their feet. Because you would expect a pass coming here, but if things start to break down for the Romulus offense, expect the quarterback to take off.
Some time running out in the quarter. A get this one off. And there's the give on the other end, and Garden City's defense shuts down Matsy. Look like Yurgalaitis 77 in there for Garden City. And time will run out, and Garden City will go to the second quarter with a 14-0 lead.
Be an interesting fourth down coming up here. I mean, you would think that it's a punt situation for Romulus, but they're facing a two-touchdown hole early after this first quarter. And again, we can't preach to Garden City enough after that first quarter. They're doing a great job with time of possession, holding onto the ball, and just punching it down the Eagles' throats.
As we do on every broadcast, we want to thank Jim Neve and all of our friends at Incorporate Graphics, located kitty corner from Garden City High School. They provide all of the swag for the volunteers at Omnidition Television and GCTV. They are do a great job with all of the high school embroidery and silk screening and other teams around the area. And Jim, a Garden City guy, lives in Garden City, grew up in Garden City. His dad and his grandfather both worked in Garden City. So we thank Incorporate Graphics, Sharon Giangrande there also. Big helpers of Omnidition Sports and GCTV, and they do great work at incorporategraphics.com.
Yep, they're keeping me nice and warm down here with this pullover, too.
Good. Yeah, this is the coldest day we've had probably since last spring. Temperature's supposed to get into the 40s tonight. So a big fourth down now for the Eagles with Cortez Johnson at the helm, two in the backfield. There's the give, and meeting him immediately was the Garden City defense, and number 54, Chaz Tennant, with the tackle for a loss. So Romulus will turn it over on downs, first and 10, Garden City.
Fantastic job by Taylor on that play. The Romulus O-line had no shot on that play. He was in there instantly, grabbed the running back, threw him down. No doubter on that play, and that's how you get the ball back for your offense. And you're close too. You're knocking on the door of the red zone. You can take a stranglehold on this game if you're able to punch in another touchdown here in the early going of the second quarter.
So a first and 10 at the 32 of Romulus. Garden City's offense back on the field. They've been on the field most of the game. Chucky Gassum at quarterback, Dockerty his center. From the pistol, give to Chellowa. Chellowa gets over the 25 to about the 23. Oh, would you call it the pistol? That's not a full shotgun, is it, Jeremy?
I would say it is the pistol.
All right.
It depends on the formation and the setup, because we've seen them in a full shotgun with a running back off to the side of Gassum on either side. So Garden City trying to give multiple looks here. But, I mean, essentially they're running most of the same plays. Like right here, it looks like we're going standard shotgun.
So the very wide out is Robert Grant. And Chellowa will just take it. And Chellowa will battle all the way inside the 5-yard line. And this Romulus Eagles team that didn't bring a lot of bodies is getting gassed early.
It is, and that's Massey on the tackle. I mean, he's playing both ways. He's their workhorse on the offensive end for Romulus. And actually on that tackle, it looked like he went a little high on Chellowa as well, got up near the helmet. So Romulus will have to be a bit careful, although
the more tired they get, too, it's going to get sloppier.
Sloppier, more frustration boiling over, absolutely.
Garden City with the roster of about 38. And it only looks like there's about 10 on the bench right now for the Eagles. Here's the give, it's Chellowa. And what do you think happened?
That is short.
So just short. I thought he got in, to be honest with you.
So yeah, he's just short there. About a yard short. No, that's about even a foot short. So
yeah, that's
expect
what I
to
thought.
See the same thing. We got Grove in here as well. So more pound it, grind it out football for Garden City, as I expect to punch this one in here.
So 10-21 and the clock running. And Garden City has yet to stop the clock today on offense.
We saw a Gassum quarterback sneak on the other goal line in the same spot.
Gassum to give to Grove.
And they gave the big man a touchdown there.
Joseph Grove carries it into the end zone. Not only does he have 50 tackles this season, now he has a 1 yard carry into the end zone. Joseph Grove. Watch this. Excuse me, pardon me, right over the goal line.
I think I'm in the cheerleaders' way here. It looks like they're about to do their push-ups.
I'm sure that's how it's been for most of your life.
Probably not.
Allman to attempt the point after. And we've got a whistle, probably motion on Garden City. I don't know if we picked it up, but Allman kind of just took a soccer shot and got one of the referees in the kneecap. So this is against Romulus, so they'll move the ball half the distance of the goal line. That was almost worth it. One of our officials just got creamed on the knee.
It's been a well officiated game so far. We can't hear them, but we can see.
Yeah, that's right. Allman will try it again. And a kick is up and it's good. So Garden City, a 21-0 lead here in the second quarter on homecoming at Garden City High School. So Garden City's Chellewa just doing it all.
Yeah, and you gotta wonder if the confidence from last week has spurred this fast start for Garden City, having beaten a team in Crestwood that's not quite as potent as they were last year. They went 8-1 last year, but still a relatively good team towards the top of the Western Wayne Athletic Conference each year. And it's gotta feel good beating a team like that. And unfortunately, Romulus is just the next victim.
Well, and Romulus, their junior varsity won yesterday, but when we look at their roster, there's only five or six seniors.
Yeah, five
so
seniors.
So that means their future is coming. And with the few seniors on this team,
Dan said if you can,
and the amount of juniors and sophomores that are on this team, with the kids come up also from JV, they're going to have a pretty nice setup there at Romulus going forward. Again, little pooch towards the sideline. And that was almost, that's going to be a flag, that's illegal procedure, but that was almost picked up by Garden City on the fly.
It was. It looked like one of the Cougars was going to dive for it to save it from going out of bounds. But regardless, this will be solid starting field position for Romulus.
Mike Roffey, I think it's Mike. I don't think it's Mark, but Mike got pretty excited on that, and he thought his guys were going to pick it up. So we'll see how Romulus does. They've had a couple of turnovers in this one already. So the Eagles will have it right at the 50-yard line. So first and 10. Hey, it's John Fleming's got the stats for Garden City.
Yep, I'll just have a nice little chat with him. And Ethan Chellewa is up to 86 yards so far on this one on 12 carries.
Wow.
In just over 14 minutes of game time.
Yeah, we have a little trouble with internet here tonight, so we're not able to get live stats. This is a lateral. This is a loose ball, and this is Garden City's football. That was a lateral that Chaz Tennant jumped all over. Well, that was 2 yards behind the quarterback. Oh, no.
Yeah. The official here sideline was pointing backwards like it was a lateral.
That was absolutely a lateral.
It was. I couldn't tell from my angle, but this official down here, the line judge on the Garden City side, was ruling that it was a backwards pass, and then you had the refs in the middle of the field saying it was an incomplete pass.
Yeah, that was just a missed call. That was a good yard behind the quarterback at the time that he threw it. A good yard, if not more. So that'll just bring up a second down and 10 now for the Eagles. Tough snap there. And almost intercepted. Pass was intended for Matthew Thomas.
And I'm not sure this switch at quarterback from Patterson to Johnson is really paying off so far, and the way that the Romulus coaching staff was hoping for.
Well, again, they thought Brown would be their guy coming into this, so you don't know. They have no one else listed as a quarterback on their roster as we look down at a 3rd and 10 now.
That's the surprising part, that they're choosing to throw it as much as they are.
Johnson tries to run it up the middle. Johnson under pursuit. He's going to lose yardage on this. And finally, Michael Nazarovsky along with somebody else with the tackle. That fell apart early and got worse.
It did, and the defense was waiting for him up the middle as well, so he had no choice but to string that out, and it was just a great job by the Garden City defense, flying to the ball, getting multiple men towards the runner and able to bring him down, and it's going to bring up a fourth down. It looks like they're going for the punt.
So deep for Garden City is Nazarovsky. I believe this is Cortez Johnson on the punt. They don't have shoulder numbers, so a little tough to make out. Here's a tough snap. Johnson, though, very poised. What a punt!
That is. That
Holy
is
Toledo! That's going to be downed inside the 10-yard line.
Oh, goodness.
Cortez Johnson with an amazing punt.
And he had such a calmness about him, too, after that high snap. He didn't look rattled at all.
Not one bit.
No, he just booted that ball.
Hey, don't forget, we will have the crowning of the homecoming queen at halftime here on GCTV. Haley Blaylock. Got to go through the list here. C.C. Canton. Houston Peterson. Sienna Sanchez Condash and Julianne Tucker, the members of the homecoming court, as you see the very fall-looking clouds over top of Metro Detroit. Didn't have any sun at all today.
This is peak fall weather in the state of Michigan.
It absolutely is. You just saw the Roffey brothers on your screen a second ago, the two coaches for this Garden City football team that both graduated from here. They, along with head coach Jim Baker, Steve Fryer, all went to Garden City High School. Chellowa on the carry.
So this has the makings of what could be a very, very long scoring drive for Garden City if they can keep moving the way that they have in this first half. Just over 8 minutes left in this first half. They're very far back, but if they're getting 3 or 4 yards a carry, as we see another handoff there, that is Chellowa.
And Chellowa still on his feet over the 20 to the 25-yard line and a first down for Ethan Chellowa.
Just controlling the game clock. That is the Garden City game plan, and it has not been deterred so far in this game.
So first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Let's see it. And there's a really, really nice block by Chaz Tennant.
Yeah, this Garden City offensive line is really coming together and getting some great continuity as the season progresses.
Here you see the concourse where they're selling Cougar toques or knit caps and seat cushions. I think this is Nazarovsky.
It was.
Watching the concourse.
It was a good job by the Romulus defense able to contain him on that play. The blockers were out there, but it looked like the defenders from Romulus were just too quick.
We want to thank everybody at Schoolcraft College too by loaning us the equipment for the wireless camera we have on the concourse level. We greatly thank them. We thank the IT department at Garden City High School for their support, as well as the buildings and grounds department for the Garden City Public Schools and all of their support. This is our 5th football game here at Garden City High School in the last 3 or 4 weeks, including a couple of Little League games. GCYAA games. Rolling out is Gassum. Gassum on the sideline, has his man, hits Robert Grant. And that's a first down for Garden City. Robert Grant, who has 22 tackles on defense, one of the options on offense for Garden City.
Yeah, that's one of the names that we haven't said yet in this game. That's Robert Grant. I know one of the last games that we broadcast, that was the Redford Union game. He had a couple big plays on the defensive side, so it's good to see him get involved in the offense. He figures to be a good player for Garden City in the coming years. He's only a sophomore, so he's just getting started.
There you see folks trying to get some hot chocolate on the concourse level outside of the concession stand run by the boosters.
I know what I'm doing at halftime.
So Chellowa in the backfield, man in motion, give to Chellowa. Chelua battles his way ahead over the 40 to the 42-yard line, gain of 5 yards on that play. And a second and five for Garden City as the clock continues to run, which is really the most important thing.
It is, and we're approaching the halfway mark of this quarter. And I tell you, if they can get a touchdown here, you go up 28-0. Garden City gets the ball to start the second half, too. So,
yeah, Romulus chose to take it. So,
things threatening to get out of hand here early.
And there you see Gassum on the run, and Gassum will pick up a couple.
That was well read by number 20 from Romulus, another player that we don't have on our roster.
Christian Chambers also there. There you see our truck. There's Noah Pickett and Megan Lynch, and Christian Gibbons, our producer-director, doing that with his phone because he found the app for that. Big crew today.
Big game. It's homecoming. We're pulling out all the stops, too.
And this is carried up over to nearly a first down. But a fourth down and one, so if you're Jim Baker, there you see the floats for this year. Trailers purchased by the Santa Land Parade Committee. So the kids could have their floats again this year, and then these will be used in the Santa Land Parade, and the winning float will appear in the Santa Land Parade. So this is a fourth down and one.
Looks like.
Is this a direct snap?
It could be.
Or are they going to punt?
It's set up for a punt, and it is a direct snap to Will.
That's what I figured. Ian Will up over the 50-yard line in the first down. I didn't think they were going to punt it there.
No. Your offense is doing too well, and it was only a yard. You're near midfield. Just hold on to that ball. Keep that clock running as we're now under 5 minutes.
So first and 10 right at midfield for Garden City. And there's a quick give. I think that's Will again. He stops for a second and gets a couple of more yards after that.
Yep, that was
no,
Chelua.
That was Chelua.
Yep, Chelua on the carry. A good job by Chucky Gassum, able to hold on to that high snap from the center as well. So good composure from the Garden City offense on that play.
So second down and a long five, short six, to the 45-yard line, officially at second and five. Nazarowski in the backfield. Give to Nazarowski. And Nazarowski battles his way just short of the 40-yard line.
So Chambers has been in on a lot of defensive plays so far in this game. And I mean, using guys both ways is, like we said, it's going to wear them down at some point. And this Romulus team is lacking the depth that they need to succeed in this game.
So third down and one for the Cougars. They want to control this ball. It's probably more important to them to run this clock down than it is to score, although a score would be nice. It's more important that they control the ball and not give it back to the Eagles.
It is, and this was a drive that started at the 8:44 mark of the second quarter back within their own 10-yard lines. And
there goes
Chelua.
And Chelua picks up the first down and more.
So, yeah,
puts on that burst of speed.
It was, too. So, yeah, this drive is now over 6 minutes as the clock will stop while the chains are reset.
Smith with the tackle as you see the chain gang.
And we got an injured Romulus Eagle.
And this is liable to happen tonight simply because these guys are playing both ways, playing a lot of downs. He doesn't want to come off the field, but he's going to have to.
It is, and the colder the weather gets, the more common injuries get as well.
Well, I guess different injuries because when it was warmer, it was cramps.
Yeah.
You know, and now it's guys getting stingers and it's guys getting cramps too, but for a different reason, not because of dehydration.
Right, cramps you can usually get over the course of maybe a drive or a couple plays, but stingers like that lasts a little while. It's a toss to Chelua.
Yeah, Chelua fights is still on his feet, fights his way almost to the 20-yard line. It's going to be really close to a first down as Thomas made the tackle for the Eagles. So second down, we'll call it one at about the 21, 22-yard line. 2 minutes remaining in this half. Again, we'll have the crowning of the homecoming queen at halftime.
You got a lead block from Groves there as well, but that is a first down, absolutely.
Yeah, Chelua picks up the first down over the 20-yard line. So Garden City, with the clock stopped at 1:47, we'll see if Jim Baker and his coaching staff decides to punch this in. Kind of running at will right now.
Yeah, I would expect for them to go for the touchdown here. I mean, if you can make it a 28-0 game at halftime, score on your first drive of the second half, you got a running clock in the second half.
There's to give to Nazarowski on Jet. Nazarowski over the 10, and Nazarowski knocked out of bounds at about the 7-yard line. So Nazarowski, the second leading runner on this Garden City team, with a nice gain there, and he got the blocking.
Well, it's a good job pushing that to the outside by Nazarowski, and it is a first and goal now for Garden City.
First and goal at the 6. Going out to the other side is Grant, along with Vandewater. Chelua in the backfield, man in motion, give to Chelua. Chelua across the middle, and he's tackled quickly.
Yeah, that play didn't fool the Romulus defense at all. And we got a flag. It looks like there's some pushing in the secondary.
And there's an angry young man for Romulus being escorted towards the sideline by his teammates. And it's tough, as you said. You're playing both ways. You're getting worn down. You're getting shut out. And you want to try to keep the other team off the board the best you can.
They're calling that on Garden City.
Interesting. I didn't see any activity on our side, but we didn't see it all either.
Yeah, there was, what I saw from this level, there was some little flurry in the secondary, and then the flag flew in. But it looks like it's going to go against Garden City.
And it might be the officials' way of policing this game.
I was just thinking that. Like, so they might be helping them out just a little bit. I mean, we don't want to say that, but.
Well, you know, just like umpires in baseball, before every second was on TV, could police the score and police the pace of the game a little bit.
So that will back up Garden City to the 20-yard line.
So a second down and goal from the 20. So much tougher situation for Garden City now.
Yeah, and you see, I see Coach Fryer talking to the offense there in the huddle there, firing his guys up.
Yeah, Steve Fryer is a pretty intense guy. And he was a good player in his day.
I believe it. I've known the guy for a long time, and I can.
Looks
totally
like he
buy
could
that.
Play now.
Yeah, he absolutely does.
He's still the biggest guy in that huddle.
Yeah. They're probably lucky he doesn't throw on some pads in practice, just to give him a look.
Garden City missing their one of their best players on the line, Brad Oman, who played both on offense and defense, or Hunter Oman, Brad's son. Hunter tore his meniscus and had some other damage to his leg, so he will miss this season, his junior season.
And that just shows what a good coaching job it has been by Garden City this year to keep that line so cohesive without one of their best players and still be able to run the ball.
Direct snap to Chelua. Chelua gets back over. Chelua is going to score. So a direct snap from the 20-yard line, and Chelua runs it in for another Garden City touchdown, his second TD of the day.
And that's picture perfect there. Romulus was completely sold on the fake there to Nazarowski, and we're going to get that extra point. Looks like it's going to be 27 or 28 point deficit here for Romulus, barring something miraculous heading into halftime.
In 35, you get into a running clock situation in the second half,
which is absolutely feasible when you get the ball to start the half.
There's a lot of movement on that line. I did not see any flags, and the point after attempt is good. So 28-0, Garden City on top of the Romulus Eagles here on homecoming at Garden City High School.
As we got the homecoming court down here on the track as well, being escorted by their loved ones.
So don't forget, we've got an election coming up on November 5th. For information about this election, go to gardencitymi.org/vote. gardencitymi.org/vote. We'll have meet the candidates there for the council election. We'll have information on the public safety millage, the sinking fund for the public schools, the library's millage, and a charter amendment. All of that can be found at gardencitymi.org/vote. So Tinsley will kick it off for Garden City.
Gotta wonder how Garden City will approach this kick again. We've seen a few short kicks, including that last one that was nearly recovered by Garden City, so keep an eye on this one.
And kind of a short punt, loose ball, uh-oh.
And that is Garden City ball, absolutely.
Mishandled by the Eagles. And Garden City comes up with it.
That was Miguel Smith and I believe Eric Massey were both fighting for it.
Hassan Shawi ended up with the recovery. Let's see it. And there you had three players right in the same vicinity. And Shawi, number one for Garden City, jumps in there to get it. And now with a 1:09 remaining, Garden City will get the football again.
This is just unraveling if you're Romulus. Anything that could go wrong has gone wrong in this game. That's the third turnover, I believe.
It is, and we'll see how Jim Baker decides to handle this up by 28. Gassum at quarterback, he's gonna pass. Gassum passes, it is complete, and a touchdown for the Cougars. Well, pass completed to Ian Will.
That answered that question about how Coach Baker was gonna approach this.
I'm a little surprised,
yeah,
I'll be honest with
that
you.
That is the second pass we've seen from Garden City in this game, and it goes for a touchdown. So they're fired up, they're coming off, there's Chellowa.
Little surprised to see him do that, but Ian Will with the touchdown catch, and Garden City could go to the locker room with a 35-0 lead. And Allman to attempt the point after. And it's good. So we will begin the second quarter, most likely with a running clock. Garden City will have to kick it to Romulus. I believe we have an injury for the Eagles on the field.
We do, and looks like the training staff is heading over, and that looks pretty bad.
He looks like he's in a lot of pain.
He is.
So a touchdown, a 1 yard carry by Gassum, a 12 yard run by Chellowa, a 1 yard carry by Joseph Grove, a 20 yard run by Chellowa, and a 30 yard pass between Gassum and number 32, Ian Will. And that's a 35-0 lead for Garden City here with 1:02 remaining in the half.
Yeah, damn. It's getting pretty out of hand, but I mean, this Cougar crowd is completely fired up here so far in this game, and they have every reason to be. This is as good as you could ask for a homecoming game. We were talking to Coach Baker before the game, and he said he thinks they haven't won a homecoming game, Garden City hasn't, since 2011. So something that this Cougar crowd has been wanting and craving for a lot of years now. So this looks like it's finally going to be the year that they get off that schneid, and it's been a dream for
staff.
And it's
not been that long since it was Garden City making these mistakes and Garden City struggling like Romulus is. So you don't give these back, that's for sure.
Right.
Tell Furby to stop talking into your microphone.
I will. He's just trying to do his job.
We want to thank all of our camera people here today. Zach King, who was on handheld, along with Brett George, who has been doing this with us since the 80s. Jason Merrill's on that lift camera. Zach Witt is on the ball follow-up on top of the press box as we watch number 24, Zach McKenzie, come off the field for the Eagles.
Yeah, it looks like it was that right knee. That's what the trainers were working on. As soon as they went to bend it a little bit, he kind of jumped in pain a bit. So hopefully he's all right around that side. But
you can't see him, Jeremy, but we're looking at Jason Merrill up on his lift camera right now. Those things make me nervous, man. They start wobbling back and forth, and the wind gets them a little bit.
Yeah, they got to have a little bit of give on them.
Yeah, I know. I like buildings. They don't give much.
That's fair. You're up in the cozy press box.
Yeah,
this
is really stable.
There, right?
I have almost never felt this room blow. So there's the kickoff. And again, a little miscommunication by the Eagles. And 21 is off to the races. He's got that tearaway jersey. Miguel Smith runs the kickoff back, gets it to the Garden City 40 before the Cougars are able to bring him down. There you see, again, a little miscommunication, but Smith wins out. And Smith, from his own 25, gets it back all the way to the Garden City 40.
That's something that the Romulus coaches have to address at halftime for sure, is you got to be able to call another player off in terms of who's going to get it, because that's two in a row now. And if they gave up the ball again on that kickoff, I mean, it's already out of hand, but still.
So Tinsley was, I don't know if he was the one that made the stop eventually. I don't know who got a hold of the jersey of Smith, but he just about tore it apart. So first and 10 for Romulus on the Garden City 40. Again, we'll have the homecoming court presentation at halftime right here on GCTV. So stick around for that one.
Now, is the running clock only in the second half?
Only in the second half.
Okay. All right. And they're just going to take a knee.
And Chambers will be at quarterback. Oh, no, Chambers walked up there. But number 11, who started at quarterback in this game, Paris Patterson, he'll take a knee. And they'll let the clock run down as long as they can and take another one. And, you know, as quick as that move was by Smith on that kickoff, you know, it proves they've got a little bit of speed.
Yeah, I don't agree with this coaching decision at all. I mean, what kind of message does this send to your players where they're
still... Well, you've had a rough half.
I know, but still, you had a good return. You're past midfield. Take a couple shots. See if you can get in the end zone and give yourself something positive heading into halftime instead of just taking a knee.
All right, so that's how the first half is going to end here at Garden City. A 35-0 lead for the Cougars over Romulus. We will take a quick break. And when we come back, we will have the halftime ceremony and the crowning of the homecoming queen right here at Garden City High School. 35-0, you're watching Omni Edition Sports. This is GCTV.
Hey, look, it's those guys.
Get some drinks.
Are you good to drive?
I'm fine.
How many did you have?
I should be fine.
You should be?
Go and step out of the vehicle for me.
See ya, buddy. Good luck.
So turns out, buzz driving and drunk driving, they're the same thing. And it costs around $10,000. So not worth it.
The Girl Scouts of Southeastern Michigan. At the Taylor Shrine Club, Tin Lizzies were able to make it today.
And the Magical Firemen. To me, it's like now it's a parade. First time the girls' swim team has taken first in their league.
They're modeling, and then they get judged by the judges at the end of the float.
Oh,
pretty cool.
Fantastic.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's meet your 2019-2020 Garden City High School homecoming court. First off, Haley Blaylock, escorted by her dad and mom and her best friend, Donnie LaDuca. Haley has a GPA of 3.5 and plans to attend Saginaw Valley State University in the fall to major in biochemistry. Haley would love to work with animals with her degree. Her hobbies include playing the guitar and piano, but her favorite thing to do is playing softball. When Haley heard her name announced for the homecoming court, she was beyond excited and could only think what a fun experience this was going to be. Her favorite memories of high school are being on the field during softball season with the best teammates in the world. She also loves Wildin with her best friend, Emma. Ladies and gentlemen, Haley Blaylock. Next up, Cecilia Catton. Escorted by her mom and dad, along with her boyfriend, Austin. Cecilia has a 3.4 GPA and is hoping to attend college at Eastern or Western Michigan University. Cecilia has been involved in every theater production at Garden City High School since her freshman year. She was extremely shocked yet very excited to be nominated by her peers for homecoming court. Her favorite memories of high school will always be sharing the O'Leary stage with all of her best friends. Ladies and gentlemen, Cecilia Catton. Next up is Houston Peterson. Escorted by her mom and dad, along with her boyfriend, Cameron Richardson. Houston has a GPA of 3.7 and hopes to attend the University of Detroit Mercy Dentistry School next fall. Houston has been involved with the activities of student council for 4 years here at Garden City High School. She's also been involved with the theater musicals. When Houston heard her name called for homecoming court, she was shocked and happy to be able to make memories with other amazing girls. Houston's favorite memories from high school are when she participated in homecoming float building every year with her best friends. Ladies and gentlemen, Houston Peterson. Next up, Sienna Sanchez Condash. Escorted by her mother and father, along with her sister, who is carrying a picture of their sister, Jessie, who couldn't be with them here tonight. Last by Sienna's side, one of her closest friends, Logan Taylor. Sienna plans to attend Schoolcraft College to complete her associate's degree and then transfer to Henry Ford or U of M Dearborn. Sienna has played varsity softball for 3 years and will be playing her fourth season this spring. When Sienna's name was called for nomination by the homecoming court, she was overwhelmed with joy and excited to make great memories with the other girls on court and thankful to have the support for the nomination from all of her friends. Sienna has made many favorite memories with the class of 2020 and her closest friend, Melina. Ladies and gentlemen, Sienna Sanchez Condash. And last but not least, Julianne Tucker. Escorted by her mom and dad, her sister Kaylee, and her best friend Alex. Julianne has a 3.0 GPA and plans to attend the College for Creative Studies to further her career in art and fashion design. Julianne has been on the Garden City Pom-Pom squad for 7 years, 4 years on the varsity, two of which she was co-captain and captain. Her favorite memory of high school is winning the state competition for Pom her freshman year. When Julianne was announced for homecoming court, she was shocked but excited that she would get to have this experience with all the other great girls on the homecoming court. Ladies and gentlemen, Julianne Tucker. And now returning to crown this year's homecoming queen is Liberty Spears, last year's homecoming queen. Libby is escorted tonight by Jenna Linden. Since graduation, Libby has been attending Madonna University studying business management. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the moment we've all been waiting for. The introduction of the 2019-2020 Garden City High School Homecoming Queen. And she is Julianne Tucker. Congratulations to Julianne Tucker and the entire Garden City High School homecoming court. It's 35-0, Garden City over top of Romulus. We'll be back with second half action from Garden City High School right after you watch this.
Garden City Civic Arena is located at Garden City Park at the corner of Cherry Hill and Merriman. The Civic Arena offers programs for people of all ages and abilities. Kids and adults can learn to skate or play hockey through programs offered by the Garden City Figure Skating Club and Garden City Hockey Association. Glow skating on Saturday night is a great way to spend a fun evening with family and friends. The arena offers a wide assortment of skate rental, and the snack bar is available during all hours of operation and has all your favorites. The arena is home to the Garden City Men's Over 30 Hockey Association and also runs a Sunday Men's League for adults 19 and up. The Garden City Figure Skating Club offers private lessons for boys and girls of all ages. Drop-in hockey, sticks and pucks, and open skating are offered weekly at the arena. The rink has a party room available for birthdays and special meetings. Call 734-793-1882 to book the room. For more information, visit gciceArena.com.
With a big 35-0 lead over the Romulus Eagles. Congratulations to the entire Garden City High School homecoming court, but especially Julianne Tucker, this year's homecoming queen. It was all Garden City in the first half. Garden City with 256 yards on offense. Romulus with only 36. Four turnovers for Romulus in the half. And Ethan Cello with 156 yards in the first half, and Garden City is going to get the ball back to begin the second half.
And I think we might have a change at quarterback for Garden City. Chucky Gassum does not have his helmet on, and I saw Chellowa taking some snaps and warming up with a few passes, so We'll see if they stick with Gassum. Looks like he's talking with the trainer right now. And we're about set for that second half kickoff, and we might have a change of quarterback. We'll see what kind of adjustments Romulus is able to make, if any. And for Garden City, it's just keep doing what you're doing and keep the clock moving. It's going to be a running clock.
And we're underway. A decent kickoff. One hopper. And run up to about the 29-yard line by Dontez Tinsley. So Garden City will start off with the ball and a running clock here in the second half. So this could be quick, folks. Don't head out for popcorn or snacks. So first and 10 for Garden City at the 30. Our thanks to everybody involved with Garden City High School and the senior class and student government for their help with everything at halftime. Also our thanks to our crew who's been out here on a chilly evening. And let's see, what do we have? And Chellowa at quarterback, he'll hand it off. And he'll give it to Nazarovsky, and Nazarovsky will pick up the first down. So, ironically, Chellowa takes the snap and doesn't run the ball.
Well, Chucky Gassum is on the sideline being worked on by the trainer. Looks like he's favoring his left knee. I'm sure he'll want to get back in there, but, you don't really need him to. Yeah.
Lead, I'm not putting him out there.
Right.
Matter of fact, I'd be a little leery to put Chellowa out there, to be honest with you.
Exactly.
So first and 10 at the 42. But yeah, Ethan Chellowa at the helm for Garden City.
I would say you get another touchdown on the board here if you're Garden City. That way you can keep it at a running clock even if Romulus scores, and then you can start putting some of the second string guys in there.
So first and 10, shotgun, and Chellowa will carry it himself. I don't know, do we call this a wildcat? Chellowa battles ahead to almost the 50-yard line.
I call it beautiful high school football where every player is versatile enough to play about three or four different positions.
So second down and two. I'm sure that's what it was like when you were in high school, right?
Well, I wasn't allowed to touch the ball, let's say that.
That's probably a good idea.
I was leading the way for the guys that had it.
Jeremy Jenkins on the sideline today, and this has worked out quite well. Little Booger McFarlane action.
Yeah, you just had to name drop it, didn't
you? I had to name drop. How often can you say Booger on TV when you're not Johnny Fever and get away with it? So the Eagles will call timeout.
Let's ask Joe Tessitore.
See, now, in order for anybody to have gotten that reference, they have to be at least 40 years old.
All right.
You have any idea who Johnny Fever is?
Nope.
I figured that.
Couldn't tell you.
WKRP in Cincinnati. That's why he got fired.
Oh. Yeah, that was a little before my time.
That's way before your time.
Just a little bit.
So the clock does stop when they call the timeout. I think they call it tips. Timeouts, injuries, penalties, and scores. That's the only time the clock will stop now. So it won't stop on out-of-bounds plays. It won't stop on dropped. So second down and two for Garden City, with Chellowa still at the helm for the Cougars. And that is Nazarovsky, and Nazarovsky will get up to the Romulus 40 and another first down.
Yeah, I expect Nazarovsky to get quite a few carries in this second half. I mean, he does get a fair amount of carries in close games as well, but this is the time to really get him some time. Because like you said, they don't really need Chellowa out there with this big a lead.
So first and 10 at the Romulus 40, Garden City up big, 35-0. We're running clock here in the third quarter. On homecoming at Garden City. So a big night and a big score for Garden City. Nazarovsky takes the handoff. Nazarovsky gets the first down. Nazarovsky over the 25.
And there's just nothing this Romulus defense can do. They're just out of sorts, and Garden City is just punching it down their throat time and time again.
So first and 10 at the Romulus 24-yard line.
awesome. I mean, for Romulus, you have some decent-sized kids on that D-line, but the Garden City line is clearly bigger than them, and it's starting to wear down. I mean, they got a nice rest at halftime, Romulus did, but again, back to the two-way players, and that ball is on the ground.
It is on the ground and recovered by Garden City, although Romulus thinks they've got it. Maybe they do. They do. So recovered by 18, Marcel Indelva. So first and 10 now for the Eagles, with the ball deep in their own territory at the 25-yard line.
Yeah, so we'll see if Romulus made any tweaks on offense, and it'll be interesting to see who they trot out at quarterback here as well. We saw a few different players out there between Cortez Johnson and Paris Patterson, and I think Christian Chambers may have taken a couple direct snaps as well. So.
Well, 21 Smith is the one that had the really nice run back on the kickoff. And, I mean, he had wheels. So it'd be interesting to see. But at quarterback for the Eagles is Patterson.
Massey off to his left. And four wide receivers.
And a whistle. And Garden City calls timeout. So even though we have a running clock, we've had two timeouts here in the quarter to stop the clock. So with 7:10 remaining in the quarter, Garden City with a 35-0 lead over Romulus here on homecoming. So a win today would get Garden City up to 4-2. Again, you need 6 to qualify automatically for the playoffs.
And I believe it is Melvindale up next. And they're arguably weaker than Romulus. That's Romulus' only win is against Melvindale. So you would think Garden City should be able to handle business there as well.
Well, the big game obviously is going to be Robichaud here at Garden City.
Absolutely.
Robichaud is quick and they are in control of the conference right now. They're going against a Redford Union team tonight that has improved greatly since Garden City saw them.
Yeah, we definitely saw some flashes from that Redford Union team late in that game. Garden City was able to jump out early, but there were some flashes. There's a high snap.
Oh, my. That goes off the hands of the quarterback and into the hands of Eric Massey. And Massey, with some wheels, picks up the first down. He's still not down. He's tackled finally around the 45-yard line. So they take a mistake and turn it into a first down.
Wow. Yeah, that was really lucky that it got tipped right to Massey. And you see how dangerous he is in space. I'm surprised that Romulus isn't running more jet sweeps and even little screen passes just to get their athletes in space.
So first and 10 for the Eagles at their own 45-yard line. And a give again to 7. That is Massey, but that time it was snuffed out quickly by the Cougars.
And that's a prime way to limit one of your most explosive players, just run them up the middle on a team that's stopping you all day.
Ian Will with the tackle for Garden City. So second down and 8. Looking to throw. And that could have been intercepted. That was intended for Malcolm Garrett, but there was nothing but blue jerseys there.
Yeah, and Patterson was being pressured as well on that play. He was forced to flush out to his right side, and he just sailed it. I mean, it didn't look catchable by anyone.
No, I was pretty surprised that he had that much time to work in the backfield.
So this is a big third down here if you're Garden City. Just get that stop, give yourself some confidence back after turning the ball over.
So from the shotgun, lobs it up in the air. Again, a bunch of blue jerseys there. And that will fall safely to the ground. Pass intended for Chambers. So fourth down and long.
I mean, you don't have your starting quarterback out there if you're Romulus. They only have Door Brown listed as quarterback on the entire roster, and you get pressed into passing situations like that.
Patterson's got an arm.
He does. He's got a little bit of a low release. He brings it up from his right hip a bit.
Romulus going for it on fourth down here, fourth down and eight. Patterson over the middle and incomplete again, intended for Chambers.
And that clock just continues to run.
And a player down for Romulus. That is Chambers. He took a little bit of a hit. And that's going to stop the clock with 4:01 remaining here in the quarter.
Let's see if Chambers is all right. That's looks like he's getting worked on his knee a little bit too.
Now we talked about the fact that Garden City has Melvindale next week at Melvindale, and the Cardinals have struggled. Melvindale new to the Western Wayne Athletic Conference, formerly with West back in the Stone Age in the Tri-River League. And then it's Robichaud here at Garden City High School. That's going to be the big one, assuming that the Cougars are able to get Melvindale. And depending on what happens with Robichaud and RU tonight, that Robichaud game is going to be huge either way. That could be for the conference championship. And then finishing the season at New Boston Huron, a road game against a pretty good football team in New Boston Huron.
Yeah, but you definitely have winnable games on your schedule as well. And if you can beat up on two of the lesser teams, be it Romulus and Melvindale and Morrell, Garden City should be feeling pretty confident going into that matchup against Robichaud. And you never know what can happen in a high school football game. You never know which team will show up. I mean, Robichaud could have an off game, and it could just be Garden City's
night. And at least
night.
They've got Roby here at home.
Absolutely.
I mean, that's a big deal.
That is a big deal. I mean, if you are close to that conference championship, I expect a homecoming level crowd, if not bigger, for a game like that.
And a flag on the play on the give to Nazarovsky. Is that Chucky Gasson back out there? I believe illegal substitution is the call against Romulus.
Yeah, the back judge was the one who threw the flag back in the secondary.
Again, first time in about 10 years we've had a referee without a mic.
That's right. We're figuring out these calls as we go.
That's right. It's not like the old days where you had a little sheet to go after. So a five-yard penalty and first down and five for Garden City at the 41. And another whistle. Chucky Gassum is back on the field for Garden City.
And it looks like we might get a Romulus timeout. Or
well, no, they're moving the chains.
Oh, it's an automatic first down.
So first and 10. They had it set up as a first and five. But because it was first down also, so that was part of the confusion, I think. The give to Nazarovsky, and he only gets a couple. Nice job breaking through the line.
And it looks like the second unit's coming in.
So second down now and about nine. So you see, yeah, Dougherty's coming off. Joey Grove coming off. Logan Taylor coming off. 24 Robert Grant coming off. So as you said, the second squad now for Garden City with 2:44 remaining in the third quarter.
And this is, I mean, it's always valuable when you're able to get guys in the game who normally aren't in the game.
Well, especially if these guys are going to be your front line next year, as you see the high snap, but Gassum able to salvage it, give it to Nazarovsky.
Yeah, it gives your starters an opportunity to rest up a bit. They're confident after a big first half and third quarter, and it gives those younger guys a chance to develop a bit, get some time, like you said, looking towards next year, but also if, God forbid, some injuries happen to some of your starters, you got guys ready to plug in.
So we'll see who lines up at center for Garden City, because that's important.
Looks like number 66, that is Nathan Combs.
So he'll line up at center, and in the pistol is Gassum. Quick give to Nazarovsky. Nazarovsky with some blocking. Nazarovsky just grabbed onto the back of Harley Rudlaff for Garden City, and Nazarovsky picks up the first down.
Romulus was trying to argue that they recovered the ball after that, but the line judge quick to say that Nazarowski was down, and he was brought down by Massey on the play.
So first and 10 at the 25 of Romulus. Big lead for Garden City here on homecoming. So you keep Chucky Gassum out there at quarterback. Just see some of the fans and the braving the cooler temperatures. It's actually very fall-like. There's a tackle in the backfield and a fumble.
That one should be Romulus ball.
I believe that was Hussein on the carry. He coughs it up, and it'll be a first down for the Eagles. So a turnover for Garden City.
But we wind down this third quarter, and Garden City's, I mean, it's been a bit of a sloppy third quarter based on what we saw in the first half, but they've kept that 35-point lead, they've kept the clock running, and the defense is just having a great night.
So first and 10 for the Eagles, deep in their own territory. This might be the only play they get off here in the third quarter at the 26-yard line. And number 7 at quarterback, that is Massey. And Massey looking to throw, and he is tackled after a short gain. And my mistake, that was Patterson again. And time's going to run out in the quarter. And Garden City's going to head to the fourth quarter with a 35-0 lead over the Romulus Eagles here on homecoming. So it's cooled off here at Garden City High School. So that reminds us the 59th annual Garden City Downtown Development Authority Santa Land Parade comes up on Saturday, November 30th at 10 a.m. And the trailers you saw tonight pulling the homecoming floats, or that the homecoming floats were built on, those will be part of it. We'll have 4 marching bands so far guaranteed for the Santa Land Parade. Of course, it lines up at Garden City High School, travels south on Middle Belt, travels east on Ford Road, and it's a great Garden City holiday tradition. The Garden City Downtown Development Authority Santa Land Parade. Go to santalandparade.com for more information, santalandparade.com, and of course, you can watch it live right here on GCTV. So a second down and 10 situation for the Eagles. Deeper in their own territory at about the 26-yard line. And again, thanks to all of our volunteers on our crew tonight. We appreciate all of the effort they've put in on these 5 football games that we've brought you. And on second down, Patterson with a quick give. There's a fumble, and this could be Garden City's ball. So just like that, Romulus gives it back. Fumble on the play, recovered by Gavin Gephardt. It was the give to Eric Massey. He couldn't hang on to it. And Garden City will get it deep in Romulus territory. And a 35-0 lead with the clock running. Jeremy Jenkins joins us now back in the press box.
Yep.
Totally different look, huh?
Yeah. Had a nice I had a good sprint up the bleachers there. Keep myself.
Maybe we should have let you get your breath before we put you back on the air.
That's all right.
So Garden City with a chance to put one more on the board. This is to give to Nazarowski as Gassum at quarterback. Nazarowski gets positive yardage, but gains just about a yard. There's a nice shot of the Cambridge parking lot and everybody, all the cars here tonight for the game. Again, thanks to Schoolcraft College for letting us use their wireless equipment that's normally used at the USA Arena in Plymouth.
Yeah, we got a great setup here at Garden City. And we pull out all the stops for these games.
So second down, no gain is the official spot. Gassum, high snap, gives it to number six again, Nazarovsky, and he'll lose some yardage. Kind of a high snap that slowed the play down. But again, we've changed almost the entire offensive line now, it looks like.
I was just going to say that. You can see the difference in the O-line in terms of just moving the line of scrimmage. And this second unit's struggling to do that. But the main goal from here on out in this fourth quarter is to get guys out of here healthy.
Well, and to get reps.
And get reps for the younger guys.
So 21 lines up in the backfield. That is Hussein. And there is a really bad snap. And downing it is the quarterback, Gassum, at about the 44-yard line. There you see Zach Witt running ball follow on top of the roof here at Garden City High School. I didn't even see Furby go up the stairs behind me. When did he go up there?
Just a little bit after he got in here. He went straight up.
I did not even see him go behind me.
He's getting creative tonight.
So fourth down and long in Garden City. We'll punt it away. So Massey is deep. Check that. It's Chambers deep. And Nazarovsky will punt it away for the Cougars. So clock running with a 35-0 lead for the Cougars. And he gets the punt away nicely. And Chambers gets it. Around the 20, and he's brought down quickly. There's a flag on the play.
It's a late flag, too.
It was Chaz Tennant with the tackle, so.
I wonder if they might get him for a horse collar.
Jim Baker putting some of his starters out there on special teams to make sure that didn't get broken for a big play. Might call a horse collar, but we'll see. No, no horse collar there. Personal foul. Well, yeah, I mean, you watch the replay back, I don't see it.
I didn't either. I mean, it kind of looked like it initially, but upon another look, I mean, it looked clean.
But as it is, it'll move the ball forward for Romulus.
As soon as that ball is set, that clock will continue to run, and they're going to have it at the 40-yard line.
So an automatic first down on the personal foul.
And you can see it on punt returns like that and even broken plays, the speed that Romulus has, and they just keep choosing to run it in between the tackles, and then that happens right there. It's a 2 or 3 yard gain instead of getting your athletes out in space.
So Massey with the run, as you see Derek Fisher. Superintendent of the Garden City Public Schools and Kevin Kramus, the voice tonight of the Garden City Cougars. So three wideouts. Three wideouts down here. And they'll give it up to middle. And Massey fumbles it.
That ball is still on the ground.
And it's still on the ground. I think, oh my goodness, I don't even know anymore.
Garden City saying that they have it.
It's getting a little sloppy now. And they say it more convincingly now as the referees and the officials try to separate everybody out. 28 came out of the huddle with it. Let's see. And it is Cougars football. So Gavin Geppert recovers the fumble. And Garden City will get the football back. Wait a minute.
Dan's got to check his.
I got to look at my 50-50 tickets.
Yeah. He's splitting it with me if he wins.
You're dreaming.
No. That's just how well I know you.
Nah, not even close. Not even close. Missed it by like 200. So first and 10 for Garden City. Hi, Furby. And it's on the Romulus 40-yard line. We need to turn the lights on for you. Is that the problem? So rolling out on the left side with the carry. That That was 21 for the Cougars. That is Hussein Hussein on the run. There you see Jeremy's made his way back up to the press box. And
it's nice and warm up here compared to down there. I can take my gloves
and
off.
And dark.
It is dark.
Because Dan likes it dark so he can see the field. Dan doesn't like reflections in the glass.
That's
so
fair.
Second down and 10.
We have a winner.
Clock rolling. Approaching 5:30 in our football game. Oh, well, there's your horse collar. 21 on the carry. That's Hussein Hussein again.
And looks like we get no flag this time around.
So third down and 10 now.
Kevin Madeline on the stop, third down.
Yeah, you got so many positives to take away from in this game if you're Garden City, especially from that first half. I mean, the second half, I mean, it's been pretty stagnant, but you've been getting some second stringers in there, and you just got to be pleased if you're the coaching staff. I was talking with Coach Fryer at just before the third quarter, and he was saying that his guys absolutely needed this and that they feel really good about it and felt good at halftime.
So Hussein with a carry, that'll bring up a fourth down, and Garden City will punt it away. Nazarowski will go in. Good snap. Gets it off cleanly. And taken inside the 5-yard line, but there quickly for Garden City. That was Robert Smith, and then a host of blue jerseys joined in.
Yeah, and if you're Romulus, this is a game you'd like to forget.
Absolutely. You're not even going to review the game tape, probably.
I know, just
nothing to
nothing
gain from,
right.
from repeating anything or seeing anything here again. So first and 10 for Romulus, deep in their own territory at the 10-yard line. And thanks to our camera people tonight, Jason Merrill, who's been here all week helping us set up for this one. Fred George, again, who's been with us since the 80s. Zach King, who's on our wireless camera today, and Zach Witt up on the roof, running ball follow. And in our truck, Megan Lynch, Noah Pickett, and our producer-director tonight is Christian Gibbons. And the quarterback rolls out, and he avoids a couple of tackles, but eventually he's brought down at the 10-yard line.
Did we get Merrill in that shutout?
We got Merrill into that shutout. Yes, we did. So Patterson at quarterback, maybe gained a yard.
Yeah, what a great night for homecoming.
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, it is chilly in the air, but I mean, this is just perfect fall football weather. And big crowd. You always want to win on your homecoming game. Sometimes it doesn't work out that way, but.
Yeah, Jim Baker reminding us before the game that it's been a while since Garden City has had a homecoming win. Patterson back to pass. He's got it up in the air. And did he catch that?
That is caught.
Wow.
I think that was Chambers on the catch.
That almost was pass interference on the Cougars, but Chambers with the reception.
And they showed some flashes of that in that first half on their very first drive as well, completing a couple passes. And then as soon as they started turning the ball over, just putting it on the ground, they went away from the passing for the most part, other than a few in the second drive.
So apparently we're having a standoff between the handheld guys. Here's a pass across the middle to 21, Smith. This is who I wanted to see earlier, and Smith picks up the first down. I'm supposed to decide who won that. And I think we're all losers, basically.
I wasn't going to say it.
So first and 10 at the 40 of Romulus. Again, Garden City will be on the road at Melvindale next week. And then the Robichaud game, that's the big one back here at home. Garden City taking on Robichaud on October 18th. That'll be senior night, so make sure you come out and check out your Cougars as they go for a conference championship, hopefully. There's Smith. He doesn't want to be tackled. I like him. He's up to the 45.
That's a perfect example of what I was saying in terms of getting your athletes in space, whether it be jet sweeps or little screen passes like that. It's been fairly successful the last two plays that they've run it. Granted, Garden City's sitting back a little bit on defense, but you got to keep the defense guessing if you're Romulus. And we just haven't seen that from the coaching staff, and it reflects in the play call.
So 1 minute mark of the game. Very quick football game with the running clock. There's a pass again to Smith, but he's tackled for a loss that time. We want to thank Lori, Matt, and everybody at Sports Venue, just kitty corner from Garden City High School, as Gephardt made that last tackle. They provide food services for everybody here at OmniDition Sports and GCTV, whether it be pizza, wings, or other great stuff. They are great supporters of the community, and they have been great supporters of the city, as you see that one thrown up into the air and intercepted by Garden City. But our thanks to Sports Venue, located kitty corner from Garden City High School. Hagado, number 80, with the interception, and that is going to wrap it up. Time will run out on the running clock, and Garden City will come away with a big 35-0 win here on homecoming. A great turnout here in the stands, and a great job by the Cougars on the field. Garden City wins 35-0. We don't have second half stats because we lost the internet, but 185 yards by Chulua just in the first half. He didn't have that many in the second half because he was at quarterback for most of it and then came out of the game. But what a great offensive effort by everybody on Garden City.
It was. This was, a picture-perfect homecoming night. They exerted their will in the first half. They drove down on four consecutive possessions and scored, and hardly had the pass to do it at all. And Chellerwell was the workhorse, as we've come to expect. He's inching ever closer to that 1,000-yard rushing mark. We expect him to get it next week. Great job by the offensive line. And shout out to the defense for getting a shutout, because that's hard to do. And they were able to come through and keep Romulus off the board.
Yeah, the Cougars pitch a shutout against Romulus. Romulus a little bit depleted here tonight. They struggled, but again, mostly underclassmen on this Romulus team. So you'll probably see improvement by them going on into next year and the year after that. So that is going to wrap it up from Garden City High School. Hopefully we've thanked everybody. Again, we've had five football games from Garden City High School. We had hoped to do a soccer game, but it got canceled due to circumstances out of our control. And that's a lot of effort by the volunteers that work here at GCTV, and a lot of great TV for your on your community channel. So for everybody here at OmniDition Television and GCTV, this is Dan York saying so long from Garden City High School. Again, the final, Garden City 35, Romulus nothing. Thanks for watching, and good night, everybody.